Hey there, Deborah Moorhead here, and welcome to Your Relationship Tips. Today, what we are going to talk about is when do you make the choice to commit? I thought that was such a great question, and I want to share some tips and ideas about that. The very first thing right before you're thinking you're ready to commit, that I want to encourage you to do is that you and your partner actually sit down and have a conversation about committing. Ask questions about why is this the right time to commit? And what does commitment mean to you? But what I really want you to do is listen closely, not only to your partner's answers, but listen closely to your own answers. Make sure that both of you are fully ready to step into a commitment, to bring your full heart and your full self to that commitment. However, before you have that conversation, there are four really important things that I want you to evaluate and look at before you even have that conversation. All right, the first thing I want you to evaluate before you even have that commitment conversation is I want you to really think about, how well do I really know him or her? How well do I really know them? Have you spent time with them? Have you seen them in lots of different environments and interactions? Have you seen them with their friends, with your friends, with their family, and with your family? What are they like in those situations? How have you seen them treat other people? And how do they treat you? So make sure you know that person really well before you even have the commitment conversation. The second piece is evaluate and decide, does this person bring out the best in me? And do I bring out the best in them? Is that what our relationship is made of? Do they encourage and support me? And ideally, you do them as well. Do they accept me for who I am today, right now? Do they help me and do I help them to really be my best self? Am I my best self with them? So make sure that this other person is bringing out the best in you. All right, the third thing I want you to evaluate before you even have that commitment conversation is I want you to look at their emotional maturity. Now, let me describe what I mean about that. First of all, I always recommend when I work with people that before you ever get all the way to that commitment, long-term commitment, is that you have had at least two big conflicts. You learn so much more about the other person when there is an actual big conflict. You see how they respond, how they react, what they do. It's so important to know that before you get into a commitment. So that's one of the things that I say will help you to really evaluate their emotional maturity. The second is, are they able to really be unselfish at times? In other words, are they able to think about how what I do affects you and put you first at times? You want to make sure that they are able to think about you and put you first and even be not selfish at times. The other piece to evaluate emotional maturity is, when they do make mistakes, are they able to handle that? Are they able to acknowledge it? Are they able to apologize for it? So make sure that there is a level of emotional maturity before you move into a commitment with that person. The fourth area I want you to evaluate really has to do with, are you guys compatible in some pretty important things like values? Life vision, lifestyles. That includes stuff like, you know, your, do you want kids? Do you see yourself with kids, a family? And, you know, do they, spiritual beliefs, lifestyles, make sure that there is a level of compatibility. You don't have to be exactly matching, but that there aren't really things that are way going to be problems as you go forward. And then you want to make sure you had your list of those non-negotiables, those must-haves, and make sure that the person meets those non-negotiables. So please evaluate those four areas before you even are going into and having the conversation about whether or not we should move towards a commitment. The bottom line then is three things. When you're ready, have that commitment conversation. Also, evaluate these four areas before you have the commitment conversation. And please, please, please have two big conflicts before you commit, because you are going to learn so much more about that person. I hope this has been helpful to guide your thinking in how to know when to make the choice to commit. I look forward to you joining us the next time. And if you like this, click the like button below and share it with anyone who it may be helpful. I will see you next time.